From a military automotive turned commercial at the request of a film star, to massive trucks able to withstand over 30 pounds of explosives, today we look at incredible vehicles of the U.S. Army. Number 14, medium tactical vehicles. Forming the backbone of the United States Army are the FMTV, or Family of Medium Tactical Vehicles. These great load-bearing trucks are an essential element in keeping the military running smoothly due to their role in transporting all of the various cargo of the U.S. Army. Originally composed of 17 different variants, these trucks share a common chassis, but are altered to fulfill a wide variety of purposes and payloads. Today, there are dozens of different medium tactical vehicles, equipped with different tools, seats, and carrying capacities ranging from 2.5 to 10 tons. Number 13. MQ-1C Gray Eagle. The MQ-1C Gray Eagle from General Atomics Aeronautical Systems is an unmanned aircraft designed for medium altitude, long endurance combat missions. It was originally created to compete in the U.S. Army's Unmanned Aerial Vehicle competition in 2002. With General Atomics hoping to win a government contract as a result of their demonstration. They beat out their only competitor in the Northrop Grumman Hunter II, and as of 2013, General Atomics has developed more than 75 individual models for the U.S. Army, with 152 more in the works. More than $4.7 billion have been spent on the MQ-1C Gray Eagle project so far, and the U.S. Army has put this investment into great use, deploying Gray Eagles on missions since Afghanistan in 2010. Number 12. Humvees. Made popular by the civilian versions that entered mainstream rotation following the first purchase by famous actor-turned-politician Arnold Schwarzenegger in 1992, the Humvee has actually served the U.S. Army since 1983. These broad vehicles were initially made to replace the use of Jeeps and other lightweight tactical vehicles ranging from a quarter to 1.25 tons. The term Humvee derives from the vehicle's full name as the High Mobility Multipurpose Wheeled Vehicle, a terminology referenced its role as a jack-of-all-trades vehicle capable of handling the tasks of many of its predecessors. Over 281,000 of these vehicles have been made to date, and they continue to be employed on a regular basis. Since 2011, just one of these Humvees with current armor specifications fetches a price tag of $220,000. Number 11. MH6 Little Bird. Specializing in observation, patrol insertion and extraction, deep air support, and forward air control, the MH6 Little Bird is a crucial part of the U.S. Army's aerial squadron. The MH6 was created to replace the OH6, another light observation helicopter that entered service in 1960. By 1963, the Army was ready to test out modified prototypes, upgrading the engine of the OH-6 for greater speed and maneuverability. This upgraded model, which featured an Allison T-63A5A engine, caught on and beat out other prototypes. And by 1965, the U.S. Army was ready to order 1,300 individual helicopters. These unarmed choppers, along with their gunship counterpart, the AH-6, have been used in most every major militaristic endeavor since their inception. They have since spawned over a dozen different versions, outfitted with all different means of weaponry and tactical equipment. Number 10. CH-47 Chinook. The CH-47 Chinook, developed first by rotorcraft company Vertol before being acquired by Boeing in 1960, is one of the heaviest lifting helicopters to come out of the Western world. This helicopter, named after the Native American tribe of modern-day Washington, weighs over 24,000 pounds with no payload and has a maximum takeoff weight of 50,000 pounds. It can speed through the sky at a top speed of 170 knots, the equivalent of 196 miles per hour, and is among the fastest helicopters in the U.S. Army. Over 1,200 of these aircraft have been built to serve in America as well as the United Kingdom's Royal Air Force at a cost of more than $38 million per unit. Number 9. MATV. The Oshkosh MATV was built to combine the protective capabilities of mine-resistant, ambush-protected vehicles like the Cougar or Buffalo with the mobility of Humvees. The 27,500-pound vehicle entered production in 2009 and nearly 10,000 have been built to date at a price tag of $470,000 each. The MATV is meant to carry one driver, three passengers, and one gunner, and can haul a maximum payload of 4,000 pounds. The roof-mounted armament is designed to where it can be operated remotely or manually, depending on the situation. Manual use gives gunners access to arms like the Milan anti-tank guided missile launcher and M240 machine gun, while the remote option uses a device called CROWS, which stands for Common Remotely Operated Weapon Systems. Number 8. The M1117 Guardian. Also known as the Commando family of vehicles, the M1117 Guardian is an armored security vehicle meant to protect personnel in combative environments. Mounted with an MK-19 grenade launcher, M2HB Browning machine gun, and an M240H medium machine gun, this heavily plated Land Rover was used prominently by U.S. military police and convoy security while serving in Afghanistan and Iraq. This hulking vehicle weighs approximately 29,560 pounds and can carry a crew of five on operations up to 475 miles in travel distance. The Guardian can handle fire from small arms, mines, and improvised explosive devices, and can even push forward after taking a hit from rocket-propelled grenades, many times deflecting them altogether thanks to the vehicle's slanted, armored surface. Number 7. UH-60 Blackhawk. Named after the historical Sauk American warrior leader, the Black Hawk has played a major part in U.S. Army operations since coming into service in 1979. The Sikorsky aircraft-made helicopter has seen action on behalf of American forces in countries like Afghanistan, Grenada, Iraq, and Somalia. Around 4,000 of these vehicles have been built to date, and in addition to the U.S. Army, the UH-60 Blackhawk is used by the Japan Self-Defense Forces, Colombian Armed Forces, and the Republic of Korea Armed Forces. Each of these twin-engine four-blade aircraft costs an average of $21.3 million to purchase. Dozens of variant Blackhawks have been made to accommodate Sikorsky's growing international customer base, as well as different U.S. Army specialization requirements. Number 6. Stryker. The Stryker family of vehicles are a series of eight-wheeled fighting vehicles fitting in over 5,000 pounds of slat armor, a specialized layer meant to guard against anti-tank rocket-propelled grenade attacks. These heavy-duty vehicles originally cost $3 million per unit to produce in 2002. By the Canadian Division of General Dynamics Land Systems. Costs were able to be reduced to $1.42 million per vehicle the following year, but as of 2012, these massive troop transporters cost $4.9 million apiece. Strykers weigh 18 to 20 tons and can be driven in four-wheel or eight-wheel drive, pushing through a variety of terrain and obstacles. For defensive capabilities, these vehicles are fitted with a variety of machine guns and other weapons, such as the 105mm M68A2 gun, 40mm MK-19 grenade launcher, 40mm MK-44 Bushmaster 2 gun, or 7.62mm M240 machine guns. Number 5. Cougar. Not quite as large as its cousin, the Buffalo, the mine-resistant ambush-protected vehicle is an infantry transport vehicle specialized in protecting against explosives and small arms. The Cougar is a $475,000 land craft built to withstand blasts of up to 30 pounds of TNT under the wheels and 15 pounds of TNT under the vehicle's undercarriage. Since the U.S. Army began incorporating the Cougar in their operations in 2004, fatalities due to improvised explosive devices, or IEDs, dropped considerably. In addition to features benefiting the Cougar in combat, this vehicle is outfitted with dual air conditioners to assist in hauling passengers, an important inclusion given troops in Iraq risk overheating as they operate while heavily dressed in 100-degree heat. Thousands of Cougars served the U.S. and British armies, with many variants available in 4x4 and 6x6 models. Number 4. The Buffalo. Built to withstand mines and protected against ambushes, the Buffalo is a heavyweight behemoth among the U.S. Army's armada of vehicles. Operating on six wheels with a large articulated arm utilized for the disposal of explosive devices, this monstrous vehicle weighs in at over 45,000 pounds and can carry a maximum load of up to 56,000 pounds. The Buffalo incorporates a V-shaped monohull chassis, an innovation specifically designed to direct the blast force of explosives away from vehicle occupants. Unlike some of the other vehicles on this list, there are only a short number used by the Army. In June of 2008, the 200th Buffalo was delivered to U.S. military, coming in handy as hazards such as IEDs became a growing problem in the Army's efforts abroad. Number 3. AH-64 Apache. While the AH-64 Apache has become a staple of the U.S. Army, this prized attack helicopter has become the primary choice for many other nations as well, including Israel, Greece, Japan, and the United Arab Emirates. This helicopter has been produced by a number of manufacturers over the years, first being developed by Hughes Helicopters in 1975, before McDonnell Douglas took over operations in 1984. The Apache wasn't introduced into service until 1986, and by 1997, Boeing Defense, Space and Security took over production of the chopper. This helicopter is notable for its twin turboshafts, tailwheel-style landing gear, a mounted nose sensor that aids in target acquisition and night vision systems, and weaponry like 30mm M230 chain guns, Hellfire missiles, and Hydra 70 rocket pods. Number 2. M2-M3 Bradley Fighting Vehicle. Developed in response to Soviet BMP tanks, the U.S. Army began using the M2 and M3 Bradley fighting vehicles in 1981. The two distinct variants of this land-roving vehicle differ mainly in cargo. While both versions carry a three-person crew in the roles of commander, gunner, and driver, the M2 is built to carry an additional 6 soldiers, while the M3 can carry additional 2, devoting space to BGM-71 missiles instead. These two variants of the Bradley fighting vehicle, along with all other minor variants, are made to transport personnel under armor protection, along with providing cover fire and suppressing enemy tanks. These weaponized machines were crafted to keep up with the M12 Abrams, as to keep up with formations as a cavalry vehicle. Number 1. M1 Abrams Tank. One of the heaviest tanks in service of the U.S. Army at 68 short tons is the M1 Abrams 3rd Generation Battle Tank. Designed by General Dynamics Land Systems, formerly known as Chrysler Defense, this tank was built to dominate in armored ground combat. The M1 Abrams is outfitted with innovative tools such as a computer fire control system, complex Chobham composite armor, a multi-fuel turbine engine, and protection against nuclear, biological, and chemical weapons for onboard soldiers.